Back to the vote. I'm here with Kevin Richmond, and we are going to be talking a lot more about Sussex Community Foundation. Kevin, should we start off with talking a bit about the lockdown and the impact that's had on communities? Spoke a lot about people throughout the lockdown period that mental health suffered a lot, hasn't it? People's mental health, accessing support for mental health services has proven a bit of a challenge. It was difficult before the first lockdown, and now we're coming at the third lockdown, it's even more difficult, if we're being honest about it. So,
yeah, absolutely. And I think that the thing that struck me most of all is, of course, the lockdown and the pandemic has just exacerbated inequality so much, hasn't it? And that, yeah. I've said so many times, yeah, I'm lucky, I've got a house and a garden, my family around me, I'm not lonely, I've got plenty of work to do, and my job's doing fine. So I'm, I'm okay, but for many people, and people very close to me, might be living on their own in a flat, haven't seen anyone for weeks, I've got no, social life's gone, work may have lost a job, or on furlough. It's a completely different experience. And but I think everyone now is feeling a real strain of the length of time the lockdown has gone on and the length of time the pandemic has gone on. So that's having effects for people, as you say, on mental health, on just the stress of being isolated for so long, the worry of how do you keep on paying the bills, keep on feeding the children, the homeschooling, all those things. I think the pressure for so many people is enormous.
Yeah.
And it's gone on for so long that people, I think, people are feeling we've really had enough, haven't they? And I think but charities have been fantastic through that process, and communities have worked together in a way that we've never seen happen before. But what's really clear now is that the long-term impact is going to be really significant, I think.
Yeah.
And it may be just as the lockdown starts to ease that we really start to see that. And I think as people are starting to be able to go out again gradually, again, for some people whose jobs have carried on, things will be okay. Some people have got more savings than they've ever had. But what we're also seeing, and what charities are telling us, there's a lot of people who've never been in poverty before. And they're suddenly finding themselves in real debt and real problems. And they're approaching people like the Systems Advice Bureau for debt advice. And that's a whole group of people that I think we should all be worried about.